Hello and thanks for watching this video. My name is Raphaëlle Sauzet and I work in Villefranche-sur-Mer in France, and I will present you now my work about the creation of a new global product of vertically resolved particulate organic carbon. The biological gravitational pump is the pump that is known now to contribute the most to carbon export to deep ocean layers. This pump has been traditionally studied from particle interception techniques such as sediment traps, and now from autonomous platforms equipped with bio-optical sensors, it is offering a new possibility to study this biological gravitational pump at higher spatiotemporal scales. The BGC Argo profiling floats are autonomous platforms that are now equipped with biogeochemical sensors that can measure biogeochemical properties such as the particulate backscattering coefficient, the BBP, and the fluorescence of chlorophyll A, the proxy of chlorophyll A concentration. The BBP is the bio-optical proxy of particulate organic carbon, the POC. And thanks to the BGC Argo profiling float, we have now more than 86,000 profiles of BBP in the global ocean. So here you have the geographical distribution of the 400 BGC Argo profiling floats that are currently in the global ocean. This is in this context that in 2016, we developed a new neural network-based method to extend biogeochemical properties to depth. This method is called SOCA for satellite ocean color, merged with Argo data to vertical distribution of bio-optical properties. So this is a neural network-based method, and more especially a multi-layered perceptron, a MLP. That is an iterative statistical method of learning, well known as a universal approximator of any complex, noisy, and non-linear distribution. So in addition to the ocean color data, we used the Argo data for the physical state of the water column because we know that it influences the nutrient and light availability that are both required for phytoplankton growth. And it is available at high spatiotemporal frequency now with Argo data. Here, I present you the architecture of the SOCA neural network. So this MLP is composed with inputs, hidden layers, and outputs. For the inputs, we have three main input components. The first one is the surface component that corresponds to satellite-derived products. So it's ocean color data and altimetry data. We have also the vertical component that corresponds to Argo-derived data, so the temperature and salinity profiles. And the third one is the temporal component. And as output, we can retrieve the biogeochemical vertical distribution. So here, the vertical distribution of the BBP, that is the bio-optical proxy of POC. So the BGC Argo data are used here as reference values to train and validate our algorithm. And the BBP profiles were filtered following the Briggs et al. Methodology in order to remove the spikes. So through SOCA, we only estimate the BBP associated to small particles. To train our MLP, we used concurrent profiles of density and bio-optical properties collected by BGC Argo floats that are concomitant with satellite products. And using this database, we used 80% of the database for the training of the MLP, and the remaining 20% of the database were used for the validation. As part of the European Copernicus Marine Environment Monitoring Service, CMEMS, SOCA has been upgraded since 2020. For example, by using additional inputs such as the sea level anomaly that gives information about mesoscale processes that are known to influence the vertical distribution of phytoplankton biomass. We also replaced chlorophyll and BBP ocean color bio-optical inputs by the remote sensing reflectances at five different wavelengths, in order to avoid additional errors that could be due to the ocean color algorithms. Also, the previous SOCA method was using as inputs four different density values for the whole water column. So we improved the temperature and salinity representation as inputs using a dimension reduction from a principal component analysis, applied on the temperature and salinity profiles. The previous method retrieved 10 BBP values for the euphotic layer, and we improved the vertical resolution of the output of SOCA method in order to have the BBP in for the mesopelagic zone. So now we can retrieve the BBP for 36 depth levels from the surface to 1,000 meter depth, which is of great interest for carbon export applications. We also improved the BGC Argo database representativeness for the training of SOCA, and we used the 23,000 additional profiles available, so it's now six times more data compared to 2016. So here you have the geographical distributions of the profiles used for the training of the MLP in 2016. And here you have the new geographical distribution of the profiles used for the SOCA training. So we have now about 30,000 satellite BGC Argo matchups, and we can see that using this new database, some areas are now representative in our database. So for example, the equatorial waters, the Indian Ocean, and the Southern Ocean. So this database is representative of the global ocean, making our method applicable at a global scale. For the SOCA validation, we use 20% of the BGC Argo database chosen randomly. So you have here the BBP acquired from the floats and the BBP here retrieved from SOCA method. And as color, you have the depth of retrieval. So we can see that the global error of retrieval of BBP that is computed using the median absolute percent difference, the MAPD, is 11%. And we can see that there is no systematic bias with depth of retrieval. Here I present you a more independent validation. So it's not, it's some time series of floats that were removed from the database at the beginning. So before split the database with the training and validation data set, we removed some time series of BGC Argo floats in order to have a more independent validation. So you have one time series here that is in the Austral Ocean and a second one here for the North Atlantic Subpolar Gyre. So here you have the BBP that is measured from the float and here the BBP that is retrieved from SOCA method. So you can see that we retrieve the BBP with an error of 20% for the Austral Ocean and an error of 16% for the North Atlantic Subpolar Gyre. You can see also that using SOCA, we can retrieve the seasonal variation of BBP, and also we can retrieve some trace of exports at depth here for deeper layers. We developed a new BBP-POC relationship in order to estimate POC from our method. So we previously used the relationship from Cetinic et al. That was developed in 2012, and that was developed for BBP at 700 nanometer, that is the reference wavelength of the BBP measured by BGC Argo floats. But this relationship was very specific for the North Atlantic during the spring bloom. So we developed a new relationship for the global scale, and for that we used a global ocean POC database that you can see here. And we matched up this POC database with the SOCA retrieval of BBP at 700 nanometer. And so we could develop this new relationship that you can see here with the plain line for the global ocean, and that is here. And if we compare with the previous one, it's here, Cetinic et al., and we can see that it was not adapted to the global ocean. So finally, using CMEMS satellite fields merged with CMEMS Armour 3D fields of temperature and salinity, we can estimate three-dimensional and then four-dimensional with time fields of BBP and POC. So these global 3D gridded POC and BBP products are available now from Siemens and online through the Siemens website. So this product have a 0.25 degree resolution horizontally. Vertically, they have a resolution of 36 depth levels from the surface to 1,000 meter depth. It is weakly filled from 1998 to 2019, but also there are some monthly climatological fields available. So here you have an example of the visualization of this product. So for example, here it's the climatology of POC for the month of November. So this visualization is available from the Siemens My Ocean visualization website. So you can add some layers here. So you, if you put add layer, you can retrieve our product. And then if you add the product, you can visualize it. So you can change the temporal, you have a temporal extension here, and you can change the depth here. So for example, also you can plot some transect with this button with lines. And so here along this transect, you have the BBP with depth, and you can see that you have some trace of export here for the upwelling part and also for the part where we have a phytoplanktonic bloom. And here, if you put a point, you have the POC with at the surface for the year with an increase during the phytoplankton bloom, the spring phytoplankton bloom. And you have here the BBP with depth for all the year. And we can see also here the trace of export just after the spring phytoplankton bloom. So this product is the most valuable source of data that is useful for the quality control of BGCRGO flood observation. It is also useful for data simulation and initialization and validation of biogeochemical models. And it could be also used to highlight spatial or temporal anomalies. We would like to develop a similar neural network-based method to study the carbon export from large particles at global scale. And the same model is under development for the retrieval of the vertical distribution of chlorophyll A concentration. It will be available through Siemens portal at the end of this year. And finally, using both four-dimensional reconstruction of BBP and chlorophyll A concentration conjointly, it offers a new path to better understand light and nutrient control on phytoplankton biomass and physiological status. I thank you for your attention, and you can download our data that are available here from the Siemens website. And don't hesitate, if you have any question, you can contact me with my email address.